Today we have Malati ma'am. He has experience of 25 years with many leading companies such as Volvo, Infosys, etc. She has worked with leadership team to help them build strategies for human resources and interacted with people across multiple countries. Today she is with us to talk on freelancing as a career. Over to you, ma'am.
Thanks, Ishwari. Thanks a lot for giving such a wonderful starting note. And thank you so much for investing your time. And so great to have you here on this webinar. So before even I begin to talk about freelancing as a career, I would like to give a brief introduction of myself and my family and what do we do, and then we move on about freelancing as a career and how does it, you know, it's really changing my life today, and truly talk about the journey that I had in the last 5 to 6 months. And in terms of your questions, I would say we can keep it at the end so that we can meaningfully answer the questions that you have. Thank you so much. So just to talk a little bit about my family and about my personal and professional life. This is Malati here. And I did join very early, in the corporate segment. I joined corporate at the age of 18 years in order to support my family. And after that is when I did my post-graduation, my graduation and the post-graduation while working in the organization. My first company was Bosch, and I did work in Bosch for about 9 years. And that was my beginning of corporate journey, that too in the HR department. So worked in various other companies since then, been with Volvo, Infosys, Praxair, Xerox, etc. Currently, I'm focusing more to perfect my freelancing journey and an excited learning every day and being part of this gig economy. Passionate about coaching, career guidance, and training, and hence I'm also part of associated with Dhyeya as a career mentor. And I started my association with Dhyeya last year, and I've done a couple of career guidance, and very excited to be part of this lovely community, truly honored with so many learned professionals who are part of this community, and then doing their bit in the career guidance area. So I'm married, and I have one kid. I manage 3 kids in my life, and I do love trekking, and you can see my family pic here with my 3 lovely kids and my husband. So this was a snapshot that we took while we had been to Himalayan trekking. So this is about my introduction about me and my family. So moving on to freelancing bit. Before even I talk about freelancing, it is important for us to really know about what is gig economy, because I would say that freelancing is a very integral part of gig economy, and how the work life is getting translated with the gig economy in place. So just one question to all the participants here. Do you feel that are you part of gig economy? Are you experiencing any part of gig economy? I would like to hear in the chat, what is that you are part of gig economy? Can you give me some example in the chat? I think it would be great to be interactive also. Can you type in the chat, are you part of gig economy? And if you are, where in your work life or personal life you have experienced having the service of gig economy? I hear one no. Anybody else? Any other takers who feel that you're part of gig economy or not? Yes, I'm part of gig economy. No. Yeah, anybody else? Okay, I'm a mindfulness coach. What is gig economy? I will talk about it. No. Okay, fair enough. So let us, okay, I am a content writer for SaaS company. Okay, great to know, Kalpana. Karthikeyan, I will cover what is gig economy. So let me put another slide which will help us understand. If you have traveled in the recent past, and I'm sure with this year, with COVID being, traveling is really not a thing to be talked of, but really if you look at last year or a previous year, have you ever traveled using some of these agencies like Make My Trip, Trivago, or Travel Triangle, where you know you have used some of them for your services, for booking your travel, booking your hotel accommodation? Yes? Okay, fine. So let's move on to another part of it, which is another slide which will explain about where are we using our gig economy. I'm sure some of it you would be familiar with, and some maybe may not be, depending on where you are in your journey in your professional life, right? So Ola, for example, Uber, Ola, I'm sure all of us would have used Uber, Ola by now. Yes, give me a quick yes, if, or say no if you have not used Uber. Yes, great. And I'm sure some of you might have also used Airbnb. Welcome, Sudhir. Their mentor, joined veteran army officer, now admin head of IT. Would love to understand what sort of freelancing is suitable. Absolutely, Sudhir. Love to have you here in this session. So a Big Basket, for example, you know, I'm sure you would have heard the Bounce, where you see a lot of these two-wheelers around. Oyo, for example, Dunzo. I'm sure, you know, most of you have experienced some or the other. Swiggy, I'm sure everybody will say yes if I tell you whether you know about Swiggy or not. So if you really look at some of these service providers that we have today, so these all are part of key players of gig economy. So what do I mean by gig economy is where you have, on one side, you have people who are giving you a service, and another side, you have a technology platform and the people who are really providing that service. What do I mean? Let's take an example of Ola or Uber, right? Ola as such, as a company, do not own any cars, right? So you have car owners on one side and you have consumers who are using the car on the other side. Ola just manages the show just by the technology platform. So this is what we call about the gig economy. So if you really see about, you know, how over the years we have gotten so used, or say this gig economy has become part and parcel of our life. And more so, you know, with the COVID affecting us this year, in the year 2020, you will notice that every business which was in the offline domain would now desperately looking for to move into online domain. So what does it mean? I mean, even it really means that there is a whole lot of opportunities that is open for people who are willing to get skilled and who are willing to serve these businesses who are struggling today, and you know, help them come online. Let's move on to the next slide, right? So we also talk about, you know, briefly talked about how does this gig economy work, right? It basically, they leverage the technology platform, right? And basically ensure that they connect the consumers and the skilled workers together. And hence, by doing that, using the technology platform, they make money, right? So that's as simple as from a layman perspective. So really, if you look at by the introduction of the Ola, Uber, what is it really benefited as a consumer to us, right? As a consumer, you know, from moving from point A to point B, which was earlier not so comfortable, but with Ola Uber coming in, it has made so much comfortable. And plus, just by use of this mobile, I'm sure every one of us will be using mobile, whether you use Android, iPhone, or whatever. A simple smartphone has changed so much of your life as a consumer, where you are really looking at just say that you are in point A and you are looking forward to go to point B. Just by one app that you download, and you simply have your service at your doorstep or wherever you are standing today, and then you reach the point B with no hassles, right? And you do have workers. That means, let's say, for example, in this Ola Uber example, it's the car driver, for example. These are really the freelancers for you, where they are doing the service, and they are connected with the technology platform, and then they, through which the consumer gets in touch with them, and the business happens. So, and then towards the end of the service, when the trip gets completed, the driver of the car gets paid, and plus the Ola gets paid for the services that is rendered. Truly, if you see in this scenario, the car driver is really not being an employee of any kind, right? He is really, whenever he wants, he can switch off and say, I'm not going to go for this trip. Or, whenever he is like saying that, no, I am interested to, do a business maybe of, so today I will do so many trips or whatever, right? If they decide, they can easily say, yes, fine. I'm going ahead and, booking so many trips today. So it's really about, so it's really truly in that sense, if you see a car driver is also a business owner, which means that he is at his mercy to either take that trip or, run the trip for that day or not. So that's what is all about gig economy that we talk of today, right? So what is the upside of gig economy? So if you really see, what has it done to us as a customers, right? It has given so much of flexibility. And also when it comes to people who are doing the service as freelancers, it has also given them so much of flexibility and freedom, right? Mobile, wherever you are, just with your mobile, you are able to reach out to, from point A to point B, just with one smartphone or one mobile phone. And not only that, connecting with the globe is really not a challenge today. Just with one webinar or just with one phone call, even if it means if you're doing a WhatsApp call, you can just connect to the world wherever they are today. Earlier, it was so much more difficult for us to reach the globe with your ISD calls and so much of hassles that we had. But today, seamlessly, you can reach out to the globe, without any hassles. Are you able to see my slides? Can you quickly type yes on the chat? Okay. Great. Lucia, people are able to see. Can you check it, Jordan, please? Thank you. No slide. Pavan, there is slide, people are able to see it. Just check with your view. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks for confirming. Yeah, some of you who are unable to see the slides can log in or re-log in. I think that should be good. Thank you. So moving on, so with this kind of, technology advantage that we have, what does it really happen to the world if you see? It's really brought in a disruption in the way we think, right? We have become so much more efficient in the way we operate things. We have so much more better facilities. Just by one click of the phone, you're able to reach out wherever you want. Just by looking at the mobile, you can order whatever you want. even with this lockdown, I'm sure though we had certain difficulties, it was not very difficult for any one of us to just, you know, pick up our phone and order online with whatever, you know, provisions or whatever daily provisions that you want for your life. So there's so much more comfort that has brought in, and you don't have to worry about having money standing in ATM queues, etc. Right? You can just with your Paytm, with your mobile wallet, with so much of technology platforms, you do the online transaction so seamlessly. Right, and better experience also, right? So you don't have to stand in hassle of standing in the queue for purchasing something. Let's imagine that with this lockdown, we did not have this technology advantage. It meant that we, you know, there's so much more chaos with offline being so weird today, right? Thanks to the technology and thanks to gig economy, where we are now able to still, even with this lockdown, we are able to get all our daily necessities with just one click today. So here I would, now that we spoke about gig economy, and initially when we spoke, few people said, I don't know about gig economy. Do you now feel how we are integrated into this gig economy? Can you type a quick yes if you agree with me? That's correct. Thanks for confirming. So if you really look at, you might be thinking that, I know I put a very weird slide, but I deliberately wanted to pick this up from the internet. Why? Because people might think, there's so much more technology happening, but where is the opportunity going? And, we are losing jobs. Jobs are not stable anymore. Every corporate is struggling in their own business, and more so in the 2020, it's become even more harder for companies to really make up their numbers. So we keep worrying on the negative side of life, where we think that there is no opportunity. But if you really look at this slide that I had put in, though I know from a visibility standpoint, it's not very great, but what it really means to say that there is so much more opportunity that is available. There's so much more newer opportunities that is existed in life today. So that is what it means. If you look at right from food industry, which is like Swiggy, Zomato, and right from online business, where every small businesses are trying to go online. There are so many, business which use technology, but not to its fullest advantage, are now looking at opportunities, how they can scale up using the technology platform. And there is so much more to happen. And if you are already into business, I am sure you would agree with me that there is so much more scope for people to go online. So what does it really mean? When we really look at, that we, on one side, we worry about where the opportunity and we don't have opportunity. But if you really look at on the other end, there is a whole lot of opportunity that exists, but just that one has to really look at, get to know the avenues of how you can get skilled. Some of it is really easily available on the platform. Of course, for every learning, you need to put your effort, you need to put your learning, etc. Like for example, even when we became career mentors for Dhyeya, we did go through a learning curve. We did attend the training. We did get to learn from masters, mentors, and then we applied those knowledge. So similarly, there are so much more opportunities that exist where we could get equipped ourselves. We could get skilled ourselves as freelancers and serve the whole lot of client population which are looking forward to come on into the online world. Moving on. So now that we talked about the gig economy and freelancing as being part of it, as I said, more and more the technology platform are evolving, there's so much more opportunity that is coming. So this was one of the McKinsey research that was done, which did tell us about, you know, how a freelancing business is booming today, where you see that more and more people are getting attracted to freelancers. And there is a reason why, which I will cover in my next slides, why people are really looking to move to freelancing as an opportunity. Top reasons why people want to move to a freelancing world as being part of the gig economy. Even before I touch upon this slide, I would like to know some of you here who are, you know, part of either corporate or who are really working in, you know, in any professional journey, would agree with me that you would have reached one point in time where you say that enough is enough in terms of career. I think I'm done with my career. Is there any breather that I can look for a change? Or is there any breather I can look for something better in my life? Can you type quick yes if you have gone through such a situation or if you're currently going through such a situation? Yes, totally. All of us go through such a situation in our life, right? And that's when we try to look for opportunities. That's when we try to look for many avenues. Is there some breather that, you know, I have done enough of this and, you know, it's really not giving me the result. At one point in time, we just stagnate and, you know, and then we think that what's more, and I mean, this is not where I belong to. Maybe I want to do something else. And what is that something else? I definitely went through that journey and I will talk about it. But I'm sure each one of you here also agree that, yes, we go through, you know, those kind of situation. Glad to know, Umesh, that you've been 30 years with corporate and started a freelance business consulting. And I'm sure you will watch for what I'm talking to right now. Right. So the best part about freelancing is, so you can decide what is that you want to do, and plus focus on learning and be the best at it, right? Get skilled at it and serve the customers doing only one thing. You don't have to do multiple things. So that's the best part about freelancing. And not only that, you are your own boss. You don't have to really worry about, you know, oh my God, what kind of boss that I have, you know, how do I run away from here? And I'm sure many of you would have heard in corporate that people leave managers and not company. And like, I have also experienced many such nasty managers in my corporate life. And not only that, you are flexible. Say, if you say that, okay, I am fine doing only this much of job, maybe 4 hours a day, 5 hours a day, or you know, whatever is the time, and earn so much of money. Or if you're really interested to scale up and really make big money out of it, there is definitely scope for it. Means there is a scope for every person as per their objectives and as per their goals in the freelancing world. And you can decide to work. Let's say you decide to say that I am very lazy and I don't get up in the morning, but I want to work maybe late hours, or I want to work, you know, maybe morning hours. So you can decide how you want to serve your customers, and then accordingly. Let's say if you are a very a late, you know, you want to do work late, and then you're not used to waking up early. You can always serve the clients across the world. There is no limitation that you need to limit yourself to one particular location. With a technology platform coming in, freelancers work from home is one advantage, and you just need an internet and a laptop and a good connection to go with. And once you have this, there's so much more that you can do and serve your customers at the time that you would like to do it. Right. So that's what I talk about, flexible hours. Then, you know, so you can do how much ever you want to. Let's say you decide as a goal that you want to earn $200 a day. And if you decide and you set a goal and you work towards it, and I'm sure you would be able to reach that. Right. Or say you say that maybe I don't want to work so much more, but I am fine maybe earning $100 a day, but I will still make up a sizable amount, but I will work X number of hours. And there is so much more scope for you to even get that, right? So that is all the beauty about freelance. So this is where I would like to talk about, when you are in the corporate journey, right? Unlike what I spoke about, so much flexibility in the freelancing, etc. In the corporate ladder, you already have a scale. You already have a job offer which can fetch you so much money. Beyond that, at the most, you might have some bit of bonuses or a variable pay, etc. But there is nothing more beyond that you could earn. But unlike in a freelancing domain, if you decide to earn more, you can definitely look at serving so much more that you can increase your earning. Ranga, I see that you raised your hand. Any questions, please? Okay. Thank you. So it's all about and plus you have those hierarchies, you have those restrictions. You can only do so much. But in the freelancing world, if you are skilled at it and if you are good at what you are doing, there's no limit. There's no limit than what you need to do and what you can earn. So let me talk a little bit about my own journey, and why did I started to, like about freelancing and started this exciting journey. So having 25 years of my experience in the corporate, I did see a lot of roller coaster in my career too. Especially, I would say in the last 5 to 6 years has been really crazy. But yeah, if you see on the good part of it, yes, I've got to do a lot of good work. I got to experience working with a global team. I do take care of global compensation, handling about 48 to 49 countries. And I do work with various teams across globe. So I would think that, that's a great opportunity that I had got from the corporate. So all the good side is one part. But if you really look at some of it from my own journey and what I have experienced in my life from a very negative side of it, where, it really led to think that maybe, corporate is enough and maybe I need to look at something else in my life, right? So that's when I started to look beyond corporate and then started to see what's more in it for me and what is that I need to do. And that's when I think I landed on Dhyeya also, where I wanted some breather, some change as a mid-career professional, where I was struggling to see what is that change that I would need. I also became a career mentor and I also got to experience there's so many like-minded people like me who are also struggling in the same domain. It doesn't matter which degree you carry, which business school that you have studied, the premier school, the highest education, the best education that you had. But in my experience, what I have, met people and listened to them and heard from them is all the same story. It doesn't matter after one point in time that you reach in your corporate ladder, it doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter from where you come. All of us go through the same roller coaster ride. Either you stagnate at one level, even though you have potential. It's nothing to do with your individual effort. But there are many times beyond your control, the things go havoc in the corporate segment. You don't, suddenly things change. Suddenly companies get sold to some other companies. Suddenly there's so much transition happening. Suddenly whatever project that meant so much life to you becomes redundant and becomes no sense. So many people who are reporting to you or as a team member you're working, they no longer exist the next day. The leadership change, and there's so much more which are not under your control, absolutely not under your control. And then you begin to think, what really hit me and where I am stuck in life. So truly, this is what happened to me, a couple of years ago, where I totally lost my 90% of my team that I was handling just because corporate took some strategy decision, which was really not so good decision. And suddenly you see that people, whenever the corporate is getting into a struggle of making numbers, the only thing that they think of is maybe reduce manpower and we will make money, somewhere. And yeah, that's right, Lokesh, absolutely. Will you suggest any tool to reduce redundant manpower? I will come to that. So there are so much more. I would rather think that instead of looking at redundancy and a manpower, if you have already hired a potential employee in the organization and in everything is fine, and you would rather look at redeploying the employees than really looking at a drastic step of throwing out an employee for no reason. Of course, there are genuine reason when things need to be taken care of in a very negative sense, which is fine. Let's say, some employee is not doing well, for example, or, it's truly a performance issue or an attitude issue. It's all fine to do. But for no reason that, just because the company has to downsize, reducing the manpower, I feel is really not a great strategy. But you'd rather, and then I've also seen that on one side you're reducing, on other side you're saying that project's critical and you start hiring. But there is no absolute congruence in really looking at an overall aspect to see whether do we have such manpower internally. Many times I think that it's always, bodies come, bodies go, and there is no soul exist in the organization, and that's how you are treated. So it's really very sad state if you see. And I have experienced myself in the last couple of years where, as I said, I work with my counterparts across globe, seeing them, especially in the high cost countries, seeing them losing their jobs with so many people that have so closely worked with them, but they have lost jobs just in no time, not because they were not good enough, but just that the company could not sustain the cost. So these were some of the nuances. I'm sure most of us face this situation. Either if you are in a corporate, you have certain challenges. If you are in an educational segment and look at from the COVID-19 situation, what it has done to an educational segment, right? There is so much chaos in the school life and the college life. Even now, people are coping up on the online education, but I'm sure, having my own kids going through this online education, I have seen that there's so much more opportunities for educational system to change, because they are just not ready yet to get online and start the class seamlessly like how they did in the offline model. So there's so much more struggle that you see. So on one hand, where you see so much of struggle, so much of, negativity, and you see a roadblock that's happening, that's when I begin to think, my mind started to wonder what next, where is that I need to land. And more so your LinkedIn or a job opportunities that you have from Naukri, etc., they all work for the companies because that's where they get the money from, right? And the consultancies and etc. But they truly show that do they work for you and really get you a career that you want? I don't think I have experienced any such true, the consulting happens on the other end, because we are more consumed as a commodity where, okay, you have an opportunity. There are companies which will pay you if I place, and hence I will place you. Not really looking at whether what is the scene there, how is the things happening there. So there is no true sense of transparency that happens even when you jump from one company to another company. While it may be good for a certain amount of time, but you will again come back to your normal self, experiencing so much more negativity around you, which are just not under your control. Moving on to next slide. So having gone through so much more in the corporate segment, I'm sure if I start talking about corporate, there's so much more story to tell, and it's never ending. It's never ending. So I would now shift my focus to how I started my journey as a freelancer, and if it really benefits any one of you attending here, I would think that that would be great. And even if it means that you need more details, because I went through this journey of, you know, really, is this freelancing for me? Can I do it? Will I be able to, after so many years of experience, will I be able to do something very different from what I did? There's so much of a question I went through. And I know, now I feel that, maybe I was crazy asking those questions. It was all just my fear, my doubt, which stopped me from moving ahead. But only one good thing that I did in this entire journey was to ensure that I stayed on, I sticked on, and I was consistently learning from my mentors, and I was consistently ensuring that I was applying what I was learning. And to my surprise, I would say in just a matter of, less than 6 months, I really am seeing the results. And I'm really seeing so much more happiness that, glad that I took this decision that I moved to the world of freelancing. So I would want to talk about my mentor here. I think who was, I would say, a key person in ensuring that, basically in ensuring to see my version two as a freelancer. Version one has been only my sad corporate story. His name is Gaurav Gurbakhshani, and born and brought up in Pune. He is a very passionate person towards online business. And he started his online business at the age of 14 years, where he found his love and passion towards internet. And not only that, he is a great trainer, where he also engages a whole lot of freelancers and enable those freelancers to ensure that we get the right kind of opportunities. And it's just not about learning a technique of freelancing. So it's a whole lot of transformational journey that I have gone through with his, under his mentorship, that I would say. And not only on the freelancing world, on the other side, he also bridges the gap with the clients where, there are many struggling businesses who are looking forward to come online, go online. So it's basically bridging to look at, how freelancers can get connected to the client-facing organizations or client-facing businesses, and to ensure that we empower on both sides in the digital platform. He was the founder of Pragmatis. That was his earlier. He started with his digital marketing agency, and with his 14 to 15 years of experience, and he has done extensive work in the international freelancing and has a lot of connects in the international domain. And then he founded online business ORG, wherein that is a place where basically ensures that the freelancers do get internationally certified. And I have also gotten internationally certified in freelancing. His name is Gaurav Gurbakhshani. He is the digital market partner in Asia. I think he is the only one digital market partner in Asia. Digitalmarketer.com is a leading provider of the digital market marketplace today, US based. He's training and mentoring us, and there is so much more happens in terms of learning and the modules, and I'm truly been honored to be part of this community. And not only yes mentors, we as a members of this community get a huge lot of opportunities where we work together as a family, we work together as a team, we work together as a virtual team where we come together and deliver projects. Moving on, so a couple of things that I would definitely talk about that I have learned in Gaurav's community and the training modules. is one really honor to have this beautiful certificate. So I can proudly say yes that I have now been internationally certified freelancers, and I am all equipped to serve my clients with the best possible services that we can provide in helping businesses go online. So what do we really learn in this community? What do we really learn in his mentorship? So we do, it's just not related to any other learning and development program. And it's just not that, it's 1 to 2 days program and then it's forgotten. We really do this on a regular basis. We do breathe the training and learning on a regular basis. We commit to ourselves being the lifelong learners. There's so much more modules that we learn from from this particular community of freelancers that managed by Gaurav. So we do a 31-day challenge where we ensure that freelancers would get completely ready in terms of whatever is needed for them to start their online journey servicing clients. And we do a 24-hour challenge where we really look at in those 24 hours, set those milestones and focus on those 24 hours to set up what you need to set up and really truly doing it to yourself and then gain that expertise so that you can then service your clients. Right? We do a daily gratitude session, and I'm sure, some of you, it might sound illogical, but trust me, in this challenging situation, doing the daily gratitude session has really helped us so much more to say that we are grateful to so many things in life that we already have. And because, this really does a magic where you don't just focus on being worried about, there's so much happening in news, there's so much negativity, people are worried about COVID, people are worried about, how many people are infected and so on and so forth. But on the other side, if you really look at, engage yourself with being a like-minded community of learners, engage yourself with mentors who have so much of experience in this knowledge, knowledge and experience in this domain, and they really give exact the practical learning that they have gone through in their real life situation, that really helps us to learn so much more. Umesh, the F, get F ready is get freelance ready. So that's what it means. F is freelance because we are the community of freelancers. We talk about, freelancing. Venkat, yes, I agree with you on gratitude part. I express my gratitude to Dheya and you, Malti, for this session. Thanks, Venkat, for this. And I always feel that it really shifted my focus and my mindset where I started to put in so much of negativity with so much negative stuff that was happening in my corporate segment. But this gave me so much breather that, yes, there is another greener side of the world that you can always have a look at it. You can always experience and huge lot of opportunity if you're willing to be a lifelong learner. And if you are willing to be part of the community and really work towards your own self-development, right? Yeah. And not only that, we learn about project management. We do learn about hands-on working with the clients, communication skills, where we do have a regular class on the communication skills, which helps you improve how you can talk to client, what are the do's and don'ts that you do with the client, and truly become world class, right? Then you are really freelance ready to serve customers, not only domestically, but also across globe. And it truly been a transformational learning for me. And we focus on really on the outcome-based goals, rather than in the corporate where goal setting made no sense to me actually. How to join Karthikeyan? I can definitely help you out on that. You could reach out to me and I can help you out on that surely. Yeah. I will give you my contacts and you could reach out to me. Towards the end of this session, I will share my contact details and you could reach out to me for any details on this. Yeah. So as I said, being part of this community and, the mentorship on a regular basis, it really helped me so much. And trust me, in just a matter of less than 6 months, I got this opportunity to serve more than 70 clients. And it was such an awesome journey. I truly couldn't believe myself, because I, whatever doubt or fear that I had, maybe was this for me, I don't know if I can do this. And there's so much more question that I had. I am into HR, and will I be able to do freelancing? But I feel how stupid I was when I was talking to myself about all these, all these questions to myself. But then I realized it was all about my fear to get into a newer world, which made me which made me feel lower, or which made me feel doubtful. But today, if I look back, I see that, oh man, I think this is a wonderful thing that I did in my life. Really truly exciting. Of course, you will have learning curve. Of course, you will need to put in your effort to reach there. But truly, truly exciting, that I would say. Yeah, Lokesh, I am in Bangalore chapter. I belong to Bangalore. Thanks so much. Yeah. So just to give you a few sample glimpse of the careers, right? I mean, there could be so much more, so much more. I am just giving maybe a bird's eye view in this slide to take a glimpse of what people would need to come into online world, right? So let's say you could build a website. Today, you don't have to be a PHP developer or a UI designer. You need to know coding to build a website. So you learn WordPress, and there's so many more tools and resources that you have with which you can build wonderful website. Honestly, with my 25 years of experience in HR, I never thought I will build website, but I have built so many websites for my client now, and I can proudly say that if I can do it, anybody in this world can do it. Yeah, so you can be a project manager. As I said, we do have multiple clients where we work with, we serve with, where you could do an account management and oversee the projects and really handhold the clients, the escalations, the communications, and with which you can still be part of freelance. When it comes to project management, it really means that you could have handled the project management in your own career. But here it's about how you could manage those and adopt those learnings into the freelancing journey, and yet you could make a life here in the project management, doing the account management. And you could be a SEO expert. Let's say if everyone who are looking to join online, and everyone would want to be on the first page of Google Sheet, Google search document, it really means that you need an expert who's really learned the skills of SEO and will ensure that you have everything right in your website, everything right in your online setup, so that you would be shown as in the first two sheets of Google, so that people can reach out to you, by virtue of which your business also get enhanced. Right? So you could be a content writer. If you are good at writing, there's so much opportunity for content writing, writing the blogs for someone, writing the content for a website, writing their social media profiles. There's so much more to do. And everyone today wants to get online, and everyone today wants to have their social presence. Everyone today wants to do their social media. But trust me, it's not easy for everyone. So it always be, helpful for people to rely on freelancers, experts who could do for it. I mean, there are a few people who does it well, seamlessly, multiple staff. But trust me, when people are going online, there's so much tech challenges that they go through. That is where I see that as a freelancer, there's so much more opportunity that you can grab. So you can be a sales funnel expert. So today we know that there's so much gap in the way the selling happens, the marketing happens in the business front. So you really can be an expert in helping and guiding your client or the customer in ensuring how they should structure their product, how they should structure their services, so that the business happens, using the proven methodology. So you will learn all of these, right from basics to adopting these in your own area of work, and plus working for your clients. So you do it for yourself, and you set up a sales funnel for yourself. You become a freelancer, and you then start serving the client. So that's how the model works. And it's truly amazing when it comes to learning so much, in this community. So see, when everybody are going online, the branding part, the promotional part of it, or the branding part of it has also picked up so much more momentum in the freelancing world. Which would mean that not only the freelancers are available for you who can help you with branding yourself or getting the best brand, to come online. I'm sure you will agree with me that whenever you see the TV advertisements, some of these ads that you will never forget, right? Be it washing powder Nirma, or be it many other ads that Colgate. Or many other ads that you see, which is always stayed in your memory. Like, how is that possible, right? These are some creative agencies behind who have always worked for it. Similarly, when businesses are going online, there is so much for a creative person to get into freelancing world to serve the customers, to ensure that they help in building the brand for the businesses. And you could be a coach or a consultant. You can become an aspiring coach or a consultant and guide many businesses, many entrepreneurs who are going online, and helping them guide. So you would also get trained on various modalities of how you can get into coaching, how you can get into consulting, and work on those areas. So what it really means is you don't have to, like, say I just listed a few career itself. This is not an exhaustive list of career, and I'm sure you will agree with me that everybody do not need to know everything. Like, say even in the corporate, you have verticals. There's somebody taking care of HR, somebody taking care of business, somebody taking care of sales and marketing, somebody taking care of strategy, somebody taking care of operations, somebody taking care of delivery. Similarly, even in the freelancing, you don't have to know everything and get overwhelmed and say, oh man, this is not happening, this is not the world for me. You just need to learn one thing, fix your niche, we call it a niche, which is your specialty, become good at it, become specialist at it, and then start earning money by serving the client. You don't need to know the whole lot of things. You can be a specialist and grow as a specialist, or you can, let's say if your skill is in the project management, then you could then work by looking at the accounts handling and then helping the clients. Am I audible? Somebody says no voice. Can you say a quick yes if I'm audible? Okay, we can hear you. Kushbu, maybe it's an issue from your end. Please check. Thank you. Okay, great. Thanks for confirming. So if you really look at, even if it means that when you're building a website, there is so much more work that goes in. Let's say you want to just set up a Google My Business, for example. It's such a simple task that you can do, but still earn a lot of money. Let's say you do thousands of business, set up a Google My Business. You just earn money by just doing that. So it's all about really fixing your thoughts on what you should be getting specialized at. Of course, you will have learning, you will have training, you will know yourself. Initially, I also went through what is that I need to fix my specialization on. But as and when I went through this journey, I got more and more clear on how I should evolve myself and where I should, you know, pitch in my specialization. And I started to work towards that. So just by staying and sticking on to this energy, learning and mentoring, trust me, I think it's really changed my world. It's really changed my thoughts. And I've been so clear that, yes, I don't mind doing this job rest of my life. And so that's about my exciting journey. And would love to hear your questions, your thoughts, and what is that you want to know from me, so that I can help you out. And and also I have a surprise for people who are here. I would be giving a free free gift towards my end of the session after questions, but would like to hear from you on any questions that you have. Let's open this for questions now, please. Will be able to show us the first slide again? Absolutely, I will be. 1 minute. Ketan. Which is my intro slide or the next slide, please? Yeah, if I have your email IDs, I could share the slides, not an issue at all, definitely. So what are the tools we can look at for development of freelancing skill? So I would say that there's a whole lot of freelancing tools and resources that are available. Let's say, for example, even now, if I have to learn something new, I would look at fresh tools and then learn and then adopt those learning in my domain. You can type in your email IDs here, and those who are requesting for slides, I can have it given to you later. Sure. And any learning curve. Somebody asked me a question. Sanjay Verma, starting freelancing work immediately will not fetch the same amount. Of course not, because every learning curve that you need to go through, I would always feel, I think this is what I learned big time in my life also. First, you need to invest in your learning, get great mentors who can help you in perfecting your journey, and then you will start to earn. I always feel that, whenever there is a downtrend that's happening in your career, you first need to hit the ground and then, be humble and learn through the mentors and people who have done it truly. They have seen results. They have gotten results in their life, right? And that's when you take off in your journey. So I always believe in it. And trust me, that's worked for me also. So I did not mind. I knew that, yes, I won't be able to earn so much more while I'm earning in corporate, but trust me, in a very short span of time, I'm able to really look at the brighter side of freelancing career, where I can say that so huge the potential is. And if I am willing to earn much more than what I'm earning today, that's a possibility. That's a mere possibility. What source I can use? What source I can use to look for freelancing job as a student? I would say that you should go through the journey of learning as a student, and then the opportunities would come in. So, like, say, I also went through this journey, and currently I'm working with my mentor, serving the clients my mentor has. They do have connections where the clients do come to us, come forward to us, right? As I said, it's a two-way approach, right? On one side, you have freelancers. On the other side, you have clients who are looking for outsourcing work to be done. So being in this mentorship, we connect on both sides, where we do get opportunity to serve clients and learn and plus earn from that project. What else? What are financial challenges and how to manage it in the freelancing career? I would say it's all in the mindset from a financial challenges. Of course, we all go through this financial crunch, but if we commit ourselves to learning from the best mentors, and if we commit to ourselves to do the bit of what we need to do, take action, I'm sure none of all this would be history, because very soon you will see yourself earning, you will see yourself so much more potential. And it's just that you need to get one client who will tell you, ma'am, this particular person did a wonderful job for me, and that's it. You will take off from there. So I would feel that in any new entry that you would want to make, challenges will be there. Let's look at it like, say, if you want to start your own business, for example, there's so much more that you have to take care of in building the business, setting up and everything. Here, rather doing those setup and investing on those capital or investing on those requirements, you are rather investing on your own self-development, your learning to become perfect. And then you're getting freelance ready to serve your clients, which means that you are ready to earn and you are ready to serve clients, and the clients will be waiting, because so much opportunity with the e-learning picking up, e-commerce picking up, every business and every small and medium business looking to go online. I feel there's so much more opportunities in this field. I would like to freelance as an executive coach. How should I prepare myself? Definitely, Sudhir, I can help you out if you could message me your mail ID, because that's a lengthy conversation, but I can definitely help you in how you can move to become an executive coach. That's a possibility. I'm into IT industry, working in various things, but I do not know which skill I'm good at. I'm half-baked everywhere. How should I find? Not to worry. I think all of us face that journey, because in some point of time, corporate gives you a very generalist experience, moreover, specialist experience. But after moving to the freelancing career, I know initially it takes a little bit of learning curve to understand where your skills lies or where your interest lies. But once you pick that up, you don't mind doing that for the rest of your life. And that's a possibility. And that's why we have mentors, who help us in this journey. How much does it cost to take such certifications, both in terms of money and time? So truly, I can talk about it, Kalpana. You can message me your email ID and I could give you those details. Honestly, it took me less than 6 months, not even 6 months, I would say, to really see a greener side of freelancing and start earning money in this domain. And definitely a sizable money, I would say. How to manage finances before you jump into freelancing? So honestly, if you ask me, Mukund, how I manage was, I was working, but as a hustle, I continued my learning journey, where I did not quit, but I continued and perfected my freelance journey, because I wanted to ensure that I have all my skills set, and then I will move out of corporate. So that way I planned my finances, so that I just didn't jump to quit corporate and then start my learning journey. I did my learning journey along with my work. If that helps. There's one thing that I would definitely like to confirm here is, we might think that there is so much of fees that is involved, and there is so much of charges that is involved in the journey. But trust me, if this journey is going to fetch you the fortune, if its journey is going to fetch you what you need to earn, or say the potential that you can earn in this journey, and the amazing amount of learning that you go through, and you become so good at what you are doing, does it really matter whatever the charges that happens in this course? I think that's how I took it. if you ask me. In terms of if you need any more details on how much it charges, how much I got paid, feel free to reach out to me and I would be able to help you out. Let me also put my my contact details, mobile number. So you could reach out to me on this number. Just message me and just mail me, and I should be able to give you the details that you are looking for. Yeah, freelance trainer teaching in trending IT technology like HTML, CSS. I am already teaching for some online training providers as part-time job. What next step to be focused emerged as a full-fledged freelance training? Absolutely, you could do that. While you might need to perhaps learn few skills to get online, and I'm sure since you are already into tech, technology and handle tech, these learnings should not be really a long time for you. You can pick it up even much more faster. And there are certain methods, the proven methods that you will learn in this course, and that should help you in in perfecting your journey on how you can do. And by being part of the community, you learn so much more because people are come with varied skill and varied experiences, and that should help you learn so much more. Do you have some failure scenarios, either your own or someone you know? Yeah, Mukund, I think success or failure is part of the game, I would say. In my own eyes, I have seen people who have messed up their own journey. Yeah, that's part and parcel of the game, but I would think that it's their own journey. If you are prepared for success, and if you are thriving for success, even you will do everything right as per guided principles, as per guided suggestions, recommendations, I'm sure you will go places. That's what I have seen in my journey. Hello, Madam. I want to become a freelance trainer teaching in, I think I did talk about this. And why did they fail? Yeah, I would say purely an attitude issue, or most of it was an attitude issue, or they did not take action with the guided thing, while it's more their own fear which said, oh no, this is not for me. But if they moved ahead, perhaps they could do well. But there are few people who were in that situation but easily come out, and they're doing very well now. After this certification, do you have any forum from where you get business, or it's networking? We do, as I said, we do have our own influencers community where we do get business, where we do serve clients. That's a possibility. And not only that, since you are a freelancer, you have perfected your journey, you are free to do other assignments that you get also. Unlike an employee commitment, it's not that you've got to be 24 hours bound to the work that you are doing. What are the flip side of freelancing? I would say whether flip side of freelancing is more of their own journey of mindset, fear, and how they deal with the situation. That's what messes up most of the time. And I would rather attribute those failures to their own journey rather than freelancing itself, right? And then you could call, yes, if you go to this route, you might not get success and then everything, but it's all ends up being on your own journey. I did share my email ID. I'll put it address again. Sure, definitely. I would love to speak to you if you need to know more details about it. So I do specialize in account management, project management, and I do specialize in integrations and funnels. What is your sustainable considering the competition in the niche area? I would say that everyone has, we believe in abundance. We don't believe in scarcity mindset. We believe that if you are ready to take on, or if you have what it takes to move ahead in your journey, you can do wonders. And there is ample opportunities for everyone in this world. And it's just not limited to your own niche. So, but only thing is, if you go more deeper into your niche and get specialized, you will get recognized in your own area very quick. So, and then perfecting your journey also becomes easier because you are not doing too many things, but you are doing one thing and perfecting it. So that's what helps. Does the community of influencers that you are part of covers any specific domain like digital online? Yes, it's everything to do with digital online, digital marketing. Digital online, digital platforms, helping people on digital, getting online. Yeah, that's a bare minimum requirement for positive. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. You should always have the positive mindset. I think that's what really helps you in this journey. Yeah, I do see a lot of emails and the phone number coming in. I would definitely connect with you. And so Ishwari, is there any way we can collect this email ID so that I can reach out to them later? I will check on that. I'm sure we do have the recording of this. I will occupied extensively in manufacturing operations, but passionate about career mentoring in niche. Absolutely. Absolutely, you can get into career mentoring. You can get into consulting. And if you ask me, there is a whole lot of digital world getting created for this. I would call it so-called guru community, the digital gurus. There's so many digital gurus who are helping people become who are aspiring coaches or aspiring digital who would want to move to digital domain, who are helping in the coaching domain where we help you to set up your business, we help you to set up your domain, we help you to set up your niche and things like that. So we have so many of them creating their own world of digital platforms. Thank you, we'll share my thoughts. Sure. Thanks, Lokesh. Any other questions? Otherwise, I think I have answered. If I missed any questions by scrolling up or something, just help me put it again and I would be able to answer you again. Why did you choose this program over other mentors available? As I said, I did try a couple of them, but I think I picked up my interest. I picked up my learning, and I started following Gaurav very closely. I was very well connected with his mentorship, and I truly believe that when you start connecting with a mentor, follow them to the T, follow their learnings, take action with what they suggest and they recommend you, and you will see results. Many times what happens, finding a mentor also takes time, but I was able to connect with Gaurav's coaching and mentoring, and that really helped me in perfecting my journey, I would say. Thanks so much for your time, and really, you could be doing so many things on this Saturday morning, afternoon, whatever, but you chose to be with me on this session. And even if it was helpful, I think that, I have done my part here and would be more than happy to guide you or support you if you want to know anything more from my end on what I am doing and how you could, if you are interested, and how I could maybe give you more clarity on that. And my sincere thanks to Dheya community for giving me this opportunity to talk on the freelancing as a career part of it. Thank you so much. And and I have given my contact details also. Please do get in touch with me for any details more that you would like to know from me. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thanks. Yeah.
Thank you, everyone. I'll just forward some couple of polls and please do answer it. And we have the recording of this session. So you all will be getting the mail related to it.
Ishwari, the poll is happening.
Ma'am, actually, I have done it, but it is taking time, maybe.
Oh, okay, I think Guru Murthy is asking, checking for.
Yeah, right. I just saw it.
I see another question, Venkat. How long is the coaching with Gaurav? I have committed to be a lifelong learner, so I've been still attending his course. Yeah. Yeah, of course, there are durations for certain courses that we do. Some are 6 weeks where you at an entry level. There's also a membership where you can continually learn and grow. There's also a 31-day challenge that happens where we learn practically setting up everything for our own business in 31 days. We do have 24-hour challenge. So there's a lot of things that we learn being part of this community. From where to get freelance certificate? Yeah, it's part of the program. We need to enroll to the program. And Sanjay, if you're interested, I think I had put in my mail ID and contact number. You could reach out to me and I can give you details. If you have it, let me know. Otherwise, I can put my contact details once again. And not to forget, let me give you the link to the you know, free ebook that you can get being part of this journey. Just give me a minute and I will post the link and you could copy the link and download it for free. It's a book that I wrote on freelancing, so ebook. So you could take this free download link. Name of the book is Aspiring Freelancers. So it's a journey for aspiring freelancers. So ebook for aspiring freelancers. So Lokesh, Deya can plan webinars in the evenings time preferred. I think Deya has been doing sessions morning and evening. I think I've seen many sessions that are happening in the evening also. I think it's weekend. Some people would prefer even in the morning. So yeah, I'm sure Deya is doing a lot of work on this end where you know, we see every day somebody or the other you know, mentors who are delivering value on the webinars. Absolutely.
Okay, ma'am, let's end the webinar now.
Sure. I hope you've all copied the free download. You could so just say a quick yes and we should end the seminar now. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much for joining in.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah. Take care.
Yeah.